It's been a while since I did a haul, an unboxing. This is going to be a little bit of a lengthy video because since I've been gone for a while, I wanted to show you guys some things that I've gotten in the time I've been absent. Don't mind this, this is just a marker because I'm doing this on the floor because I'm super lazy and I don't feel like having my regular setup. But yeah, I'm excited to see what I've added to my collection and talk a little bit about it. And then at the end, I'm going to talk about my experience going to a K-pop concert. So let's just jump right into it. Since the last time I did an unboxing, here's one of the first albums I got. So this is EXO's third full-length album. It's Exact. I've been trying to, you guys know that I'm trying to do my EXO collection and it's taking some time. Exact is a hard one to find. This one is the Chinese version, but I'm personally not like, I don't really have an issue with like Korean or Chinese versions. Like I'm not like a stickler for only having Korean versions, especially if the photo books aren't different, then I truly don't care. And with the Exacts, the photo books aren't really, really like different. There's like maybe one different picture. So I couldn't find the Lucky One version in Korean anywhere, so I decided to find a Chinese one, and I found one in perfect condition. I also do have the Monster version, but that's not coming till a little bit later, so I'll do that in a separate video haul. So they gave me the little EXO figurines. Let me take them out. They're so funny. They're so cute. So this is obviously Sehun. Sorry. Mostly because it's angry, you can absolutely tell. this one looks like it's Chin. And then this one honestly would rather be anywhere else, so it must be Dio. These are so cute. I actually want to collect all of them, mostly just because they're adorable and they really fit their personalities so well. Yeah. So let's take a look at it. I know you guys have probably seen this one unboxed, but for the sake of my channel, I just wanted to flip through, see some of my favorite pictures. Classic CD. So this one was the interview version. Now, I remember a long time ago, I did look up this interview, and I think it was really well done. It was cute. I don't know if there's any differences in the Chinese interview or the Korean, but I think not. Also, I really love this photo book because I really loved, you guys know by now if you've been watching my channel, I'm such a sucker for like casual looks. I'm such a sucker for like a normal boy, normal girl concept. And this gave me, you know, school personalities. And I loved it. Also, this is one of my favorite Dio pictures right here. I want this blown up. And like on, I don't know what I want it on, but I want this picture blown up. It's one of my favorite Dio pictures. This was such a good concept for him. And Lucky One was such, oh, so it was like, a, it was almost like a, I remember this was like a dual title track. This was Lucky One and Monster. Everybody talks about Monster 24/7, which it's a banger. We know this, but I loved Lucky One, and I don't think Lucky One gets talked about the way it should. Schumann is off to the military. What a sad time to be an EXO, an XOL. Somebody said on, I think it was Twitter, that Chin is now officially the only XOM left, and that, like, legitimately killed me. But like, is he? Yeah, never mind. He is. Again, I miss Lay in photo books. I miss Lay in EXO photo books so much. Like, when are you gonna come back to us? His outfit at the Met Gala was super basic, so I was a little disappointed. but most guys who go to the Met Gala are basic and disappointing, so in essence, he kind of fit right in. I'm talking about with their outfit choices. Like, there's only, like, a few choice guys who actually follow the theme. And a few choice girls. To be honest, nobody's... A lot of people aren't theme at the Met Gala, but... Whatever. But it's nice that he got that invite. Like, that's good for him. Exposure. Connections. I miss this era. This was such a good era. And then this was Platinum Blonde Kai. I really love this picture of Chen. Yeah, this was good old Platinum Blonde Kai. Love it. You know, Platinum Blonde Kai is sometimes hit or miss, but in Lucky One, I felt like it was a hit. And, also, I want more Kai undercuts, and everybody's doing the mullet, and I can't stand the mullet. So I would love this in black. Sir, if you don't mind, if you want to get to it, if EXO is really coming out with another subunit and you're a part of it, please this, please in black. Very greatly appreciate it. Okay, and that's... Exact, and the photo card I got from this was Chanyeol. I don't think I've ever pulled a Chanyeol photo card, so this is nice to have. So that was the first thing I bought. Let me put this back in the case. Ah. So this next one. So I got Nuyce's new album, Happily Ever After, and this is the Ever After version. And here's, so I didn't have plans to buy a Nuyce album. I don't even really, I follow Nuyce, but I don't particularly care for them that much. But this is a really, really good album, and it's, OT5. It was really nice to have all the members back together. And, you know, Bet Bet, it's quite a title track. They just won off of it, which congratulations to them. If I'm hearing correctly, this is Nuyce's first win, like, ever. Someone correct me if I'm wrong. But, yeah, I kind of wanted it because I listened to the whole album just on a whim. And the whole album is fantastic, so I just went ahead and, you know, I just went and got it. Because why not? So. And, you know, sometimes when things like this happen, I don't know, it just felt right to, you know, just grab a Nuyce album with OT5 and, you know, just do it that way. I really did like the concept, though. Of what they're going for. I mean, and it's not, again, this isn't like a new concept, boys in suits, you know, it's not new, it's played, but you know, it's classic and it works. Sometimes you just gotta get your grown and sexy on. JR Jr. is my bias in Nuyce, if I had to just have one. Oh! But Aaron really looks good in this. I said that like I haven't flipped through these photo books, but that picture of Aaron just gets me every single time. I don't know how I feel about Baco as a blonde. You know, I don't know. I think blonde's not my favorite on him. I'm already a dark-haired supremacist, but... Some people, you know, they still are pulling it off. It's just, it hasn't grown on me yet. But again, it's not like I am the biggest Nuyce fan. So, you know, you're not catering to me. I love this half of the photo book. I am so basic for being such a sucker for a leather jacket. He looks so good. It's criminal. It's criminal. This is a really good picture, though. Yeah, so congratulations to them on their win. I want to say that my favorite track off of this album is... It's on the tip of my tongue, and now for some reason, I cannot think of the name. When I get to the credits, I'll point it out. These are good looks. And you know what? I have to say, with the exception of me and not knowing if I'm, like, down for Baekho being blonde, you know, solid hair era for everyone. Nobody has a bad cut. Which, I mean, it's the bare minimum to ask of a K-pop group, yet it gets screwed over so many times. So, peeps on you guys for having a winning era, but also just, like, having a winning era, if you know what I mean, like, looks-wise. Let's see. It's Different. Yes. Different is my favorite song on the album, followed closely by Bass, then it's Bet Bet, then Talk About Love, and then probably Fine, Universe, and Segno. I mean, and the last four, like, off of a whim, but I know for sure that Different is my favorite. It's a really solid album. Kudos to them. Pledis doesn't really do a lot of things right. So give credit when it's due. And the CD plate I got was Aaron. And this was like concept postcard. A little fairy tale concept postcard. And here are my photo cards. First one is I got Baekho. And then second one, I got Aaron. Yeah. And so there's a newest in my collection now. Moving on. So I got Lay's third album, which is, oh my God, I can never say it right. Namana, whatever. Lay's third album. I can't for the life of me say, like, tongue twister words. It escapes me. Now, I got this one, had absolutely no plans yet. No, let me not say no plans, but I had no plans yet on collecting Lay solo albums. I knew for sure that I was going to get into, like, you know, EXO solo projects. Like, I'm going to get Chen's album eventually. You know, as my EXO collection tries to get completed. I snatched this, though, because I was in Barnes & Noble so randomly. And you're like, you turn around and then there's this, like, BTS, this is, like, BTS shrine section of Barnes & Noble where they just, like, have all of their, like, J14 magazine covers. I don't know. Whatever. And I saw it and I was like, oh, cool. So, because I'm not, like, a big BTS person, nothing really was, like, popping out to me. And then I saw EXO's Don't Mess Up My Tempo, and then right above it was Lay's. And I was like, this is such a random assortment. And yet, because I have no impulse control, I had to buy it. I was like, when else do you get to easily consume, you know, and purchase K-pop CDs in your good old regular American stores? You know, now that it's becoming more accessible, it makes my life easier. Someone with low impulse control and a collector's habit. So here it is. But this album is actually gorgeous. So if you can see the detailing in the plastic, there's some really, really, really beautiful detail work happening on the inside, on the inside clear plastic. Cracking it open, and then you can kind of see it folding over on the carpet. It came with this, which is a stack of Lay cards to replace the fact that there's no regular, like, photo card. So I'll get into this after. Let's take this out. And then let's get into the photo book and the CD. The CDs real quick. I'm only doing this one more in depth too, because I don't think I saw a lot of these CDs. I don't think I saw a lot of Lay's album unboxed. I don't know. Maybe I did. Maybe I didn't. So it's this album, I guess why it's in Barnes & Noble is because it's technically a US debut. So this is the China version, Chinese version, CD plate. That detail work is insane. It's so gorgeous. And then CD 2 is the English version of all the tracks. So I listened to the album obviously when it first came out, and I listened to the English version. It's nice. I mean, I listen to both versions, but I do tend to listen to the English version more just because, you know, it's nice to hear Lay speak to me and like know what he's saying right off the bat. You know, there's a familiarity there. Oh, I can't get this in. Okay. There we go. So let's get into the photo book. Let's move that to the side for a while. So here's the front of the photo book. And then here's the back. Another, a lot more of that good, like, detail work. It's very, very pretty. Sorry if any of the shots are messed up. I can't see what's going on in the camera because of the way I have it set up out of pure laziness. So I'm just doing my best. So I do like Lay's solo music. I do. It takes a minute to grow on me every time, but I do end up liking it. Lay's solo tracks for me aren't just like straight off the back hits, but they grow on me. Like Sheep, which I will be getting at some point, was such an interesting album, and it took a while for me. Lay looks so handsome. Yixing. I love his side profile pics. That sounded weird when I said it, but I know it's not a weird statement. I know people love side profiles. Look at Lay with the little shirtless, giving you at home, leisure day off, spend the day on the couch bed. It's all a vibe. This photo book is like maybe one-fourth of the size of the Sheep photo book. I feel like once I buy Sheep, I'm going to just be buying like Lay's own personal portrait photo book. But these pictures are so nice. He's just really handsome. But you know what? Like, as much as I miss Lay in EXO, because that's, you know, that's his start. That's family for him, and I want the boys back together. I do appreciate when foreign idols get to go back home and get all the appreciation that they weren't getting elsewhere. You know, it's just, I don't know. It's nice to see them really, like, not to say that, you know, the Korean market wasn't appreciating them, but, you know, it's just really nice to see some of the foreign idols get put back to the forefront. Because a lot of them, they're so talented. And they deserve to be recognized for their talents. And if they have to go home to do that for a while, I'm not mad at it. I like this photo a lot, and I like this photo. I like these photos in nature. Again, it's basic, but I love it. Also, Lay looks really good in yellow. I want to see him in more yellow pieces. I think one of my favorite B-sides on this album, besides, well, Lay You Down is considered a title track, isn't it? I did really enjoy Thing For You. Thing For You and Hold On were really great. Same with Tattoo. Very pretty photo book. Let's put these back. And so, I'm not gonna go through all of them because there's like 4 million, but these are basically like, they're essentially like tarot cards. Not really, but kind of. Of like laying this like fantasy world or whatever. They're very pretty. And then the back of them. Very mystic, very cosmic. Yeah. So that was a fun little Barnes & Noble buy to add to the collection. Okay, moving on. Ooh, so much. TXT. Now, this is absolutely random, and it's such a funny story. So, whatever, TXT was hyped, big hit. I, like, wasn't, like, counting down for their debut. Didn't really care, I just figured when they debut, they debut. And, when Crown came out, I thought it was a really cool video. Like, I enjoyed what they did with the video. Did debut, I thought the song was good, and I feel like had it not been so hyped, I would have liked the song better. I just, because there was so much hype around their debut or whatever, that when Crown came out, I was like so underwhelmed that I kind of was like, anyway. And Somni's Noir came out same day, and I was like, okay, well, one is grabbing my attention far better. Anyway, I had no plans to get this album at all. But what happened was somebody was doing, like, just, you know, a content creator that I enjoy was doing a live stream on Sming or whatever like that. And before you could get to their stream, they were doing a TXT quiz for a free album. So I was like, whatever, I'm already here, I'm gonna take the quiz. So I don't know anything about TXT. I truly don't. So every time a question came up, like, I wouldn't even really read it. I would just click on an answer and be like, whatever. This is 100% true and 100% the craziest shit to ever happen to me. I got every question right and somehow landed at number two. And the number one person, like, had already ordered it and was like, whatever. So then I got it and claimed it. Now, I felt like a part of me was like, should I claim it? Like, it could definitely go to someone who's a stan. And people will probably be like, you should have given it up. But I totally did claim it, mostly just because I was like tripping out that I was like second place. Like, it tripped me out that I literally guessed and had the probability of second place. But here's why I don't regret, like after I claimed it and they like, and Sming was like, oh, okay, cool, we're gonna send it to you. Like, I was thinking about it and I was like, oh, when I get it, I'll probably just, I think I'll maybe give it away. I'll probably talk to it on Twitter. The thing about it is, because it was coming to me, I decided to give another listen to the whole album. And maybe it's because it's been some time and distance since it first came out and all the hype and all of that good stuff. I actually really enjoyed it. I enjoyed the other songs. I thought it was like a solid debut. I finally got into that cat and dog song that everybody's been talking about. Like, the lyrics are so geared to someone who's not my age. but, you know, it was like a weird, like, kids bop Travis Scott. I don't even know how that works. I should have done this whole explanation while flipping through it, but I'm gonna make this very quick and just like skip through it because I still don't know these people. But the point is it was a surprisingly chill album. Blue Orange Age was really, really good. Reminds me of a lot of like old school kind of like boy groups and stuff. Yeah, but it's a very basic packaging, but I don't know, it's cool. I still don't know like 10% of these members, like, or 90% of these members' names. Like, I know three of their names, only two of them can I match the face to the name, and then the other two, I don't know. They're cute, they have, like, the photo book has a very basic, cute concept. Hwinning Kai is my favorite. I feel like he might be everybody's favorite. I don't know. He's obviously mixed, and I don't know, it just makes him stand out just because he's like the obvious foreigner of the group. And like, that doesn't, I don't know anything about him. He could be born in Korea. He might not like be foreign like on that level, but like, just because he's mixed, he stands out just because like he obviously looks different from the other boys. But he's also really cute, and he does his thing. Like, I saw him in the video and I was like, oh, you have good presence. The only other one I know is Taeyeon. No, that's not him. I want to say I could pick his face up out of the crowd. Let's see. Taeyeon is this one, right? I could be wrong. I don't know. Whatever. You guys know how I got this album now. But I did like them. Eventually, I'll take the time out to like look through this album and really like try and match these names to the faces. But by the time I saw the cat dog video, some of them had already changed hair colors, and I was like, oh, this is a mess. So I'm gonna have to actually try on that. So this is why I suddenly have the Dream Chapter star. So that's my TXT story. And halfway through the stack. So, in a very...